Hi there guys, Joe the Pet here with CoinOpTV, and today we have a Skyrim tutorial on how to get the magical companion Erandur. So let me go ahead and show you where we're at on the map. So to get to this quest, you want to go to Dawnstar, which is straight north of Whiterun. As you can see right here, it's a good starting point. So once you get to the entrance of Dawnstar, there's two different ways you can go. I just jump over this rock right here, and you're going to want to go into this little inn right here. And that's where you're going to meet your quest giver. Once inside, head to the left over here and go ahead and talk to this guy in the hood.
What troubles you, my daughter?
And that's actually Erandur. That's the guy you're going to get later on. And just go ahead and go through the motions. I'm going to go ahead and, for time's sake, skip through most of this. But choose the first possible option right there out of the three.
These dreams.
And basically what he's saying is this whole town is plagued by bad dreams and they have trouble sleeping, and he's going to tell you why. And if you want to see through that, go ahead. But like I said, I'm just going to try to save time here, so go ahead and skip through this and go ahead and agree to help him and be like, yeah, I trust you, dude, no problem, no problem. And once he's done talking, you'll get the quest like that, and then you're going to go ahead and go outside.
The tower on that hill is our destination. People around here call it the Tower of Dawn.
So like Erandur says, you want to go to that tower, but you don't have to wait for him. The quest says wait to follow, but he'll just sit there and he'll meander for a long time, and he's really old and slow. So just go ahead and run up there. I mean, unless you just want to like tag along with him. But I just went ahead and ran forward and just basically follow the hill up. It's really quite easy to find your way up there. So once you find these ruins right here, just take a left and you'll see a door. And there's going to be like three little spiders. They're pretty easy to whoop down. I'm only level 6 at this point, so you should be able to beat them no problem. Especially if you're further on in the game. But once you're done with those, just go ahead and take a right and go to the door. Go inside if you don't want to wait for a Erandur. And then once you're inside, go ahead and head back out and it should be waiting for you. And you don't have to do this. You can just sit there and wait for him if you want. I'm just not very patient, so I'd rather just go ahead. And then just talk to Erandur like this. And then go ahead and wait for him to go inside and then follow him. And once you're inside, head over to this wall. And eventually he'll meander over there and he'll light it on fire. And magically it'll open for him. You can't do this yourself. He has to do this. And once you go forward just a little bit, go over by this iron grate. And Erandur is going to come up and play show and tell with you.
Behold the skull of corruption, source of Dawnstar's woes. We must reach the inner sanctum and destroy it. Come, there's no time to lose.
And once you get to the bottom of the stairs here, there's going to be a couple of guys come back to life. Just make short work of them, you know, just do whatever. I like to light people on fire, because that's how I roll.
Damn it! The priest must have activated this barrier when the miasma was released. Impossible, actually. I wonder. There may be a way to bypass the barrier, but I must check their library and confirm it can be done. I'll still have my key to the library. Whenever you're ready.
Again, I'm just skipping through the dialogue so we can save on time, but definitely go through it if you do this because it's cool. And then go ahead and turn around and head up these stairs, and over to the left there's a door, and just wait for him to get over there because he has a key. He has to unlock it for you. And once he finally opens the door for you, just keep running right along and you'll see a couple guys right here, and just dispense with them however you choose. My preference is light them on fire, but you're going to want to keep a mental note of this room, and I'll show you why later. But for right now, go ahead and head over to the left and just hug the wall and just keep going forward, and eventually you'll come to these stairs down here. I like to flank around to the left because there's two wizards or mages inside there, so I just like to go around and hit them from behind. They're a little bit distracted by Erandur, so while they're doing that, I just light him on fire, and the other one runs away. While he's running, I'll come up behind him again. That's usually what happens. A little bit forward, and there we go. And that's done. See, now you get another quest. So just talk to Erandur again, and he's going to give you a different quest. This time he's going to ask you to find a book. And now we're going to go up these stairs here and back to that room I asked you to take a note of earlier. Just jump around a little bit. Hop up over here. And hop here. And I just like hopping. I'm like a little bunny rabbit. Anyways, the book's right here. Just read it and then go ahead and take it. And now all I have to do is go find Erandur again. And I'm just going to be a little bunny rabbit for a minute. And fall down here and turn around. And now he's over here by these bookshelves.
Yes, my dog. Let me take a look.
So after he flips around the book a little bit, he's going to ask you for dialogue and do all that stuff. And go ahead and be his test subject because you're going to have to be if you want to get him as a companion. And so now we're going to get a different quest, which is going to lead us to the laboratory. And I'm going to skip a couple rooms ahead to the laboratory. And it's not too far away, so you won't get lost or anything. But just kill these couple of people that are up top. There's an orc and another priest. And then down low, there's going to be another orc and a priest. If you want to, you can sit there and watch them kill each other and just take out the other one that doesn't die. And we'll go ahead and finish off the survivor. And after that happens, you'll see the little bloop. Go ahead and turn in the quest, talk to Erandur again.
Now that they've been dealt with, we need to find the torpor.
So all you have to do is turn around, and there's a bookcase. And just grab this red vial here and go up and talk to Erandur again.
Yes, my daughter.
And just go ahead and say that. I believe you. And then after the dialogue, he's going to use a potion. And then you can probably use it just anywhere, but I'm standing in front of this door because that's where you end the quest. But anyways, go ahead and select the torpa.
The orcs have breached the inner sanctum, Brother Varen.
We must hold. We can't allow the skull to fall into their hands.
But no more than a handful of us remain, brother.
Then we have no choice. The miasma must be released.
The miasma? But brother...
We have no alternative. It's the will of Vermina. And what about you, Brother Casimir? Are you prepared to serve the will of Vermina? Then it's decided. Brother Casimir, you must activate the barrier and release the miasma. Let nothing stop you.
So this is really cool. You actually travel back in time, and your plan is this other priest. But you don't really have to do anything except run. You don't have to stop and fight anybody. You don't even have to, like, you know, acknowledge anybody. Just run around. I got lost a couple times. But you should be able to find it. Just go back to the beginning of the level where that door was. And you just run around, and that kind of looks familiar. See those guys? You just run past them. They don't even acknowledge you. They're too busy fighting each other. Just keep going and going and going. Oh, nope. See, brick wall. Nope. Nope. There we go. And over to the right. And whoa, excuse me. And going through here. No. See there was a wall right there? Just pull that chain to the left.
Not so fast.
And just give it a few seconds and it'll run out of the little lightning bolt or whatever is going on there.
Worked. Mara be praised. You vanished after drinking the torpor and materialized on the other side. The inner sanctum lies ahead. We must reach the skull and put an end to Dawnstar's troubles. Lead on, my friend.
Okay, so what you want to do here is just go forward. You don't have to wait for him. It says follow him, but, you know, you can just go ahead. And you have to just take out these random people that are coming back to life. And then you're going to want to go ahead and go through those several rooms. And you come to this door, open it up. And Erandur will be magically there. I wish I could teleport to the end of the level. But go ahead and save this because these guys are kind of tough.
Wait. Baron, Thorin, you're alive.
No thanks to you, Casimir. I no longer use that name. I'm Erandur, Priest of Mara. You're a traitor. You left us to die and then ran before the miasma took you. No, I was scared. I wasn't ready to sleep. Enough of your lies. I can't allow you to destroy the skull, priest of Mara. Then you leave me no choice.
We fight to the last. Enough.
I knew Varen and Thoric. They were my friends. Is this punishment for my past? Is it Mara's will to torment me so? Yes, you're right. If they needed to die so that Dawnstar could live, then it was worth the price. It's time. The skull must be destroyed. If you'll stand back, I'll perform the ritual granted to me by Lady Mara. I call upon you, Lady Mara. The skull hungers. It yearns for memories and leaves nightmares in its wake. Grant me the power to break through this barrier and to send the skull to the depths of oblivion.
He's deceiving you. When the ritual's complete, the skull will be free, and then Erandur will turn on you. Quickly, kill him now. Kill him and claim the skull for your own. Vermina commands you.
Forgive me if I don't appear relieved. This temple has taken its toll on me. In time, I believe I will. I'd constructed a meager shrine to Mara in the antechamber where we entered. My intention was to spend the rest of my years here, burying the past and praying for forgiveness. But instead, I wish to offer my services to you. If you ever wish to journey with me, I'll be here. There's no need to thank me. What you did was for the people of Dawnstar. If anyone should be thanked, it should be you.
So head on back to the beginning of the dungeon and head outside. And once you're outside, go ahead and talk to your companion if they're still around.
I'm right behind you.
And go down to, it's time for us to part ways. And they'll be like, alright, well, I'll talk to you later then. I'm gonna be back home. And then go back inside. And once you're back in the temple, go talk to Erandur and ask him to follow you.
Let's not waste any time.
And just in case you're curious as to like what kind of a fighter Erandur is, I was actually away from the controller, and this happened while I was waiting for him to catch up to me. And he's pretty much just owning the dragon, saving my life. And I come back just in time to like be alive. I mean, he's holding down the fort right now. I mean, there we go. Did I come back yet? No, I'm still gone. Look at how much health I have left. And he's still holding it down. He's grabbing aggro. I go, what the heck's going on with your dragon? But yeah, he saved my life. So I mean, that's kind of an indication of what kind of a fighter he is. It's pretty awesome. Well, hopefully y'all found this tutorial helpful, if not entertaining. If you like this, make sure and like, comment, and subscribe. This has been JoJo Pet for CoinOpTV. Thanks for watching. Y'all have a good day, and I'll talk to you later. Skizzle!